Good morning. I want to welcome everybody to Solomon's Porch. If it's your first time here, this is not your ordinary church. We just want to open us in a little prayer. Father, we want to thank you for this day. We want to thank you that we live in a country where we can come and worship at our choice. And Holy Spirit, we know you're going to come and show up today. And we just ask that everybody here's eyes be opened, ears be opened, and we hear what you have to say. You speak to everyone here. In Jesus' name, amen.
Me found. For some reason, God likes to wake me up in the middle of the night. I guess he thinks I don't need to sleep. So it's usually 3-4 o'clock in the morning. So this morning was about 4. And I just woke up with this pursuit thing on me. This pursuit thing that he was trying to talk about. And it was kind of cool because it hit me that, you know, like more than 2,000 years ago, he sent his son for us knowing that I was going to screw up yesterday, knowing that I was going to mess up 10 years ago, knowing that I was going to do this, do that, you know, just miss the mark. But it didn't matter because his goal wasn't to come and save the sinner. He's not like this, like literally last night I saw Iron Man, but you know, like, I don't know which one it is, but when he makes all the big Iron Man and then they're like, there's like super big versions of them. That's not God. He's not Iron Man who just jumps down and goes, here I am, I'm here to save you. You need me. No, he's that loving father that comes beside you and says, I'm here because I need you. He's pursuing us because that's where he wants to be. He wants to be next to us. He wants to be with us. He wants to be with us in the junk we're going through. And he's always, always, always going to pursue you fiercely. Most oftentimes, it's, are we going to recognize what's happening? Are we going to say, okay, you know what? I guess I'll just kind of wave the white flag on this one. What do I have to lose? I mean, really, sometimes that's the point we're at. What else do I've lost it all. I've messed it up. I can't fix this on my own. What do I have to lose? What do I have to lose? Psalm 23 in the Passion Translation. So verse 6, so why would I fear the future? Why would I fear the future? Why? For your goodness and love pursue me all the days of my life. That's what it comes down to. That's what it comes down to. He's not the big superhero come to save us. He did, but he did because he loved us, not because we're such messes that nothing else will ever fix us. Because there's lots of things out there that can make us feel better, right? But he's the only thing that's gonna really fix it.
Thank you.
precious cross of grace. How great the love, how strong the hand that holds us.
Time service this morning. We're going to take our tithes and offerings this morning. If you need an envelope, there'll be envelopes in front of you and the seat in front of you. Lord, this morning we want to thank you, Lord, for all the grace and all the blessings and, Lord, all the things you have done for us. Lord, we want to thank you that you're faithful to us, Lord, even when we're not always faithful to you. And Lord, this morning as we bring our tithes and offerings, our sacrifice of praise up to you, Lord God, Lord, we pray that you would bless it, Lord, and multiply it. And Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for all the things you're doing in our lives, Lord, and all the things that you're going to do in the future. Well, Lord, you're saving the best wine for last. And Lord, we thank you for this time that we have to be able to give unto you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Before Why don't you find somebody, give them a hug, tell them God loves them, say hello, find somebody you don't know.